Welcome to tonight's Parent Academy. Our March theme is to be here and to set goals. Tonight, we are very, very fortunate to have Mary Kate Santulli and Lori Talbot. They are going to speak to us about raising resilient girls. They will talk about energy. They will talk about manifesting. And at the end of our program tonight, everyone who is here will create a vision board for themselves. We're very excited for this program. And without further ado, I turn it over to our presenters.
Hi, I'm Lori Talbot. I am the owner and founder of Happy Girls Sparkle. I was a teacher here in Cranford for 33 years. And when I retired, I saw a need for empowering women, girls. And so my company empowers girls from 5 to 105. I help them to tap into their superpowers to become the very best version of who they are.
Hi, I'm Mary Kate Santulli, and I am the owner of actually two businesses, Little Flower Essential Oil Blends and the Curious Heart Shop in Westfield. I am a Reiki master teacher, I am a clinical aromatherapist, and I'm also certified in the formation of natural body care. I create natural body care products, essential oil blends, scrubs, lotions, you name it, all natural. I custom blend with the intention of imbuing positive energy into all of the products that I make. In addition, I also sell crystals and other metaphysical jewelry and other hippy-dippy stuff that just help you to lead your best life and get you on your path to being your best self.
I believe in pink. I believe that laughing is the best calorie burner. I believe in kissing a lot. I believe in being strong when everything seems to be going wrong. I believe that happy girls are the prettiest. I believe that tomorrow is another day, and I believe in miracles. Audrey Hepburn. So, without further ado, here we go, manifesting. So what is manifesting anyway? Probably before you girls were born, there was a book that came out that was called The Secret. And it was all about if you think about it, you can have it. And it sounded so hokey when it first came out. But the fact of the matter is that thoughts do become things. So today we're gonna ask you to really think about, well, what is it that you want? As you move forward in this world, who do you wanna become? What do you want to achieve? What do you want in your life? And that's what manifesting actually is. You put your heart and mind and soul into it, and even the smallest things can come true and can be the secret of your success. It's the law of attraction. If you've heard of the law of attraction before, it's all about the law of attraction. Okay, so what are you trying to manifest? Now, you can be very general, or you can get super, super specific. And we often use this example of, I want a beach house. It doesn't tell you if I want a beach house in New Jersey, if I want a beach house in South Carolina. I can just say, I want to manifest a beach house. But if I want to get really specific, I want a beach house on Long Beach Island, in Love Ladies, on the beach. I want it to have 4 bedrooms. I want it to have a deck. I want it to be close to the local so that I can go there for my coffee. Very, very detailed. Either way works. It's your choice. Do you want to be very general, or do you want to be more specific? Now, you might say something like, I want to be hooked up with Justin Bieber. What is it that you like about Justin Bieber? Is he kind? I want to meet a fella who is kind, who is talented, who's a great singer, who's a great dancer. So those are the things that you're going to think about as you begin to think about what you want to manifest. You're going to think about, what do you want in relationships? What do you want as you go further in school? What do you want in your future? What do you want to feel when you're in your home? What do you want to feel like when you're in your body? Do you want to feel stronger? Do you want to run faster? Sing better? I don't know that you could sing better, but as a fine example, to sing more. I want to have a career on Broadway. Poor Hope, I'm sorry. But that's my point. You need to really think about what is it that you're looking for to manifest. And that's why you have paper on your desk right now, because we want you to take a few minutes to really jot down some ideas. Get yourself focused on what it is that you're trying to attract into your life.
So there is a foe to the law of attraction, and that is you need to bring yourself into alignment with what you're trying to attract. And this kind of beckons back to what I was talking about in the beginning about chakras and your energy. So if your energy isn't in alignment with what you're trying to bring in, you're going to have a really hard time bringing that new idea, that new trait, that new car, that new relationship. You're going to have a hard time. You're going to be hitting blocks because we need to release the past. We all go through things in life, and the adversities that we confront and are up against are brought to us as a gift. I know it doesn't seem like it sometimes, because some of the things that happen to us are pretty tough to handle, but it's brought to us as a gift so that we can learn, grow, release, grow through it. When we don't do that, when we kind of just stay where we are, like a deer in the headlights with what's happening to us, it creates an energetic block, and it really makes it very difficult to bring anything new into your life. This is particularly true as we grow older. We start to see that thing that we really want is hard because we're not learning the lesson from whatever the adversity was. We don't grow when everything's great and everything's, you know, when everything's hunky-dory, peachy keen, and everything's going your way, life's good. You grow the most in yourself and who you are as a person through your adversity. So as you go through life and you come up against these obstacles, just remember that look for the lesson. What lesson am I supposed to be learning through this struggle right now? And when you learn it and you accept it and you say, you know what? I'm accepting it. I see the lesson and I'm good with it. It's okay. I'm going to grow from it. You're going to be able to release it then. And then you're going to be ready to move on. So the next step is believing that you really deserve whatever it is that you're trying to bring in. And that can be hard too, because there's sometimes that, some things we do where we tell ourselves little lies and we say, I'm good with what happened, I'm good. But maybe, you know you're not. You can lie to yourself, you can't lie to your higher self, and you can't lie to the universe. They know when you really don't believe that you deserve what you're trying to bring in. So you really have, that's a hard one. It's a hard one, especially as we get older. We know some of the things that we do in life, some of the things that we're up against in life. We say, well, I did that and yeah. So I really don't deserve that new relationship because I screwed up the last one. Learn the lesson, move through it, accept that you did it, whatever it was, forgive yourself for it, and then know that you deserve whatever that is. Maybe you get a car, you crack up the car, and you say, and this might have happened to me in high school, you crack up the car, and I say, oh, I'd really love another car. I don't deserve it. I just cracked up the last car. And then one's father comes to you, and this really is a true story, 100%. I cracked up my parents' car in high school. They were away on vacation, and my brother tortured me for 2 weeks, telling me how I was Deadsville. Don't play this down in Bethesda, Maryland, by the way. For 2 weeks, I was tortured. And you know what my father did when they got off the, they came and they got out of the limo, the car was situated, and I was upset, and I was very, very sorry for it. And he goes, about a week later, he goes, I'm gonna get you your own car to crack up. Boy, was my brother annoyed. All those posts of those cabriolets. But I had really forgiven myself, and I knew that, you know what, my punishment had actually been given to me, handed down by my brother, not my father. And I really believed I deserved another car, another shot at the, and I took very good care of it. And I had immense gratitude. That is the last piece of that little puzzle. Immense gratitude. I didn't get the cabriolet that I wanted, the convertible cabriolet. However, I did get a sunroof in the car, that the 87 Chevy Spectrum that my dad bought for me. And I was very, very grateful. It was a really good car. It ran, it lasted me through college, and it wasn't exactly what I wanted, but it was close enough. It got me where I wanted to go, and it took me with my friends all around. So those are some really important steps when you're trying to bring in that new thing into your life to remember. So step three is visualizing, then noticing, and then meditating. So visualizing is, can you see in your mind's eye what it is that you're trying to bring in? For instance, I'm kind of the poster child for manifesting, because back in 2013, I saw in my mind's eye a store with old furniture in it. I didn't know what it was. I thought maybe I was going to have a secondhand shop. I didn't know what it was, but it always stayed with me. And I would continue to just kind of like riff on that mental image. And then as the other pieces of the puzzle started coming together with the Reiki and the natural body care, and then the workshops, I started to see it started to come together like a really beautiful puzzle, a mosaic of what I really wanted. And I could see it in my mind's eye. As I closed my eyes, even throughout my day, I'd say, ooh, I can see that being in my shop. So being able to visualize and actually, you know, put it into that piece of that puzzle where you want it to be is really important. Noticing. Yeah, and it was just something that I saw, and I really didn't know that I had no, trust me, there was no grand plan. I like to say if I actually knew what I was doing, I'd be dangerous. It really is just using your intuition and instinct and really following the breadcrumbs. That's what I like to say. I follow the breadcrumbs and it just leads me to the next place. So noticing, and you'll notice, like when you're looking, I think a car is a great example. When you see that car that you want, you see it everywhere. And that's part of manifesting, because now you're picking up on it and it's helping you with that visual cue. So noticing it around you, the person, your friend who has a new boyfriend and is in a really great relationship, you notice it and you appreciate it. You go, wow, that's what I want for myself. So those are the types of things. When you notice it, you appreciate it, you have gratitude for it, and then you can visualize it. Well, what's the best way to visualize? Meditating. It's a tough one, I know. People don't like to do it. But, you know, I think everybody just beats themselves up a little bit too much about it. You do the best you can. The universe knows that you're trying your hardest. And it's okay if, you know, you fall asleep, if you start thinking about what you're going to eat for dinner tonight. It's pulling yourself back into that meditation. And the more you do it, I know, it's like anything else in life. The more you do it, the better you get at it. So when you're able to visualize it, you are now going to bring the intangible into the tangible. And so with that.
Your mind doesn't know the difference between real and imagined. So the more you can make it feel, you can feel the way that you want to feel in this new version of yourself. The more that you're actually experiencing it in your mind, the mind doesn't know the difference between real and imagined, and so it helps to bring it into reality. So,
okay. There we go. So now we're going to get comfortable. As comfortable as you can get in a school chair. And it's a short meditation. It's not going to be long. And if you do fall asleep,
I'll poke you.
All right, so I invite you to get comfortable. You're sitting upright with your feet flat on the floor, keeping your spine straight yet relaxed. Or you can slump a little. There's no grading here. We're going to begin with gratitude for all that we are and all that we have, and for taking time in your busy day to connect with yourself. So now I invite you to close your eyes if you've not already done so, and start to become aware of your body. How it feels against your chair. Soften your jaw. Allow your tongue to fall comfortably between your teeth. Allow the muscles in your neck and shoulders to soften and relax. Exhale any negative energy out of your body. Continue to focus your consciousness on your body as we begin a little deep breathing. For a count of six, inhale deeply through your nose. As you inhale, feel your body further relax and soften. Again, notice the touch points of your body. Hold your breath for a count of four. Then gently exhale for a count of seven. And gently push any stress or negative energy out of your body. We're going to repeat that two more times. Inhaling deeply for a count of six. And holding for four. And then gently exhaling for a count of seven. And one more time, a deep inhale for a count of six. And hold for a count of four. And then gently exhale for a count of seven, pushing that last little bit of air out of your belly. And now we can continue to breathe normally. I am now going to ask you to bring focus to your feet. Wiggle your toes and become keenly aware of the energy in your feet. Begin to visualize cords or roots forming at the base of your feet. These cords or roots are what connects you to the earth and keeps your consciousness rooted in your body. Visualize a warm energy coming up from the earth through the floor and into the soles of your feet. This energy feels warm and nurturing. It relaxes your toes and feet as it begins to travel up your legs, spreading its gentle, nourishing warmth up your calves, then to your knees and into your thighs. Your lower body begins to truly feel relaxed. As you continue to breathe, you settle in more deeply and enjoy the warm and nurturing heat as it travels up your pelvis and into your belly. Your belly feels warm. It even may tickle a little as this energy is full of love and compassion. As you continue to breathe, you feel even more relaxed and comfortable. This warm, loving energy moves its way up your torso and into your heart. Your heart immediately responds to this powerful yet gentle energy with love and self-compassion. You feel deep and immense love for yourself, who you are, and who you are yet to become. As you continue to breathe, this warm, glowing energy wraps its warmth around your shoulders. It feels like a warm, lovely blanket enveloping you in love. Your hands begin to radiate a warm, loving energy. As this beautiful energy makes its way up your neck, it releases any residual stress or tension, leaving you completely relaxed. Finally, this loving energy makes its way past your mouth and nose and eyes into the center of your forehead. Here, this gorgeous energy rests for a moment. It gently sends a glowing warmth into your mind's eye, gently burning away any negative thoughts or blocks that will keep you from realizing your true potential. As it gently continues its work, you begin to see who you will become. Take a moment to really absorb this feeling and visualize what you want and who it is you want to become. You can see the future and its infinite potential. You feel hopeful, confident, and full of love. This gentle energy reaches its final stage, moving out of the top of your head. As it does so, it lovingly wraps itself around your entire body, creating a bubble of loving, compassionate energy. This is now your energy. Full of infinite possibilities. You feel nothing but love and gratitude for yourself and this beautiful energy. You make a promise to yourself to maintain this energy as you journey into the person you are about to become. Use this meditation as often as you need to as you manifest your future self. And when you feel ready, you can begin to come back, wiggle your fingers and toes, and you can open your eyes. And thank you for taking this lovely journey with me to your future self. Namaste.
So, If you have never created a vision board before, these are some examples of what it might look like. So what you were jotting down before kind of gives you a beginning on what it might be that you're looking for. The bin right over here on the cart is filled with magazines. We have scissors for you, we have glue for you, and we have beautiful canvases for you to use as your canvas for creating your vision board. Now, as you cut them, I think probably for me, I would cut things out first and then decide how to place them onto the vision board. You've got plenty of time to go looking through a variety of magazines for words, pictures that exemplify what it is that you are trying to bring into your life. Then, when you are complete and you've glued everything on and you go home tonight, put your vision board in a place where you're going to see it often. I have a vision board right on the bathroom door in my bedroom where I'm looking at it when I go to sleep at night, when I wake up in the morning, and I'm manifesting and bringing in the things that are on my vision board into my life.
It's your visual cue. It's a constant reminder to be mm-hmm. a visual cue.
And you can see on the first, on the second, obviously,
you
this...
You can guess what she's trying to manifest, over here. I think she's trying to manifest her future self, making money.
Mm-hmm.
She wants to be sexy, savvy.
Yeah, after 40. After 40. But it looks as if, you know, she wants to have World Craft, Strategic Support Solutions.
So she's trying to manifest her future self.
Junk is another's treasure. Yeah, definitely her.
I think the other one is rather
self-evident. Yeah, they want to travel.
All the places they want to go. So, you know, for those of you starting to learn how to drive, maybe you want to put a bunch of different cars. Colleges, if you're getting ready to apply to college or the next phase after high school, what you want to do, you know, in the next phase after CHS is in the wind. So many possibilities.
Yeah, let your mind, let your dreams be your guide.
That's the whole point. Have fun.
So we invite you. These might not be the most conducive seats to being creative. We have the whole library.
Yeah, so you can spread out.
These are beautiful tables. So if you want, maybe we'll all move to the over here, and I'll bring the magazines over and the boards and the paintbrushes and the glue, and we can get started.
I would to be a better cook, because I'm not a good cook, but I want to be a better cook.
That's wonderful. Are you going to put that up in your kitchen now?
I'm going to put it where I always can see this vision board. Yep. Or maybe put it, you know, in my office where I work.
And what are you taking away from tonight? What did you learn tonight?
Well, I learned tonight, you know, you need to have a vision if you want to achieve something. I think that's a good reminder. Yep, that's what I like. I think it's important to have a vision. Yep.